oppressed. Seven cups is free. He's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star, the ruler of a nation, my God. Heaven and earth adore him, angels bow before him. He's the blessed one, the great I am. He's the great I am. Nobody like him. He's the great I am. He's holy and mighty, Lord. He's the great I am. 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 Choir, help me sing. You are the great I am. Yes, you are.
You are the great I am.
Nobody like you.
You are the great I am.
That's who you are.
You are the great I am.
Oh, you are the great. Hallelujah. Why don't you jam your hands to the King?
My God is good.
Hey, a double double. Everything a double double. Promotion double double. Your money double double. Your cash double double. And a double double. Somebody shout. In the morning when I wake up, I will sing my praise unto you, my Lord. I will shout, I will dance to you. You have been my help forever and ever. Hey, my God is good.
Hey, my God is good.
Hey, my God is good. Double double, promotion double double, promotion double double, promotion double double, your car double double, your house is double double, everything a double double. Jehovah, 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 you are good. Jehovah, you are good. Jehovah, you are good.
Jehovah, you are good.
Jehovah, you are too much.
Jehovah, you are good.
Jehovah, you are good.
Jehovah, you are good.
Jehovah, 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 Jehovah,
Jehovah, Jehovah,
Jehovah, Jehovah, you are the Lord. Jehovah, Jehovah, you are the Lord. For my liking, give a dance unto the Lord.
Yeah.
He reigns. He reigns. He reigns. In your life. In your life. In your marriage. In your relationship. He reigns. He reigns. In your career. He reigns. In your life. Jesus reigns. Yes, he reigns. Yes, he reigns. Yes, he reigns. Jehovah reigns. Jehovah reigns. Jehovah reigns. Jehovah reigns. He is lifted high. He is lifted high. He is lifted high. He is lifted high. Let's do this. We go to hear your name. Come on. Hey, baby. I want to see you. Oh, oh.
Hallelujah.
Out of the house. Hallelujah. 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 Changed by your love. In this place, in this presence.
In the presence of your majesty.
We give you praise. Everlasting King of glory, we give you praise. Our Lord and God, the Most High God, the creator of the universe, the one who was, who is, and is to come, the Messiah and the soon coming King, the one who saved me and saved this congregation. We sing majesty unto your holy name. Majesty, majesty. Kingdom authority. Father, we worship you this morning. Be thou exalted in the mighty name of Jesus. Great is thine faithfulness. O Lord, my Father, there is no shadow of turning with thee. This morning, can you lift up your voice to the Lord and tell him he's faithful? Father, we thank you because you're a faithful God. You're a good God. You're a kind God. There is no God like you. We in Grace Assembly, we have searched far and wide. We have gone to the end of the nations. We have found no one like you. We found that you are Jehovah, the Most High God, the one who is better than the best, the one who is richer than the richest, the creator of the universe, the one who stands alone and he is God, the one who stretches the clouds across the heaven like a curtain, the one who suspends the heart with invisible pillars. God, this morning we reverence you. Grace Assembly reverence you. The choir reverence you. The congregation reverence you. And the congregation of the elders, we say thank you. Lord, we give you praise. We adore you. We exalt you this morning. Glory be to your holy name, O Lord. For in Jesus' mighty name we have worshipped. In Jesus' mighty name we have worshipped. Holy God. Father, we present ourselves before you this morning as a living sacrifice. And Lord, we ask that this morning, every dead item in our lives be washed away by the blood of Jesus and the mighty name of Jesus. Father, because we're asking that the gates be lifted up and the everlasting doors be open, because you, the King of Glory, you have entered in. To you be the glory, O Lord. We'll lift you up, Daddy. This morning, Lord, our heart cry, Lord, is that you accept us and accept our worship in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, in the meeting of today, we ask, O Lord, that you're the supreme God. We ask that you lift burdens off our shoulders in the mighty name of Jesus. That as many of us stepped into this auditorium, O Lord, believing that there's a God that rules the universe, that Lord, you will meet us at the very point of our needs in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we ask that you touch our hearts, O Lord, and make it hearts of flesh, that we may receive of you this morning what you have in store for us, the showers of blessing, the mercy drops, the great breath of life. Lord God, we open our hearts to receive you this morning. Enter in the mighty name of Jesus. We ask that you come in today. We ask that you come in to stay. We ask that you abide with us still in the mighty name of Jesus. And Lord, as you be speaking to us individually, corporately, collectively, we ask that you grant us individual ears in the mighty name of Jesus. Grant us the corporate ears in the mighty name of Jesus. Grant us the collective ears in the mighty name of Jesus. And Lord God, at the end of the service, we want to ascribe all all the greatness back to you. Because without you, we are nothing. And we confess this morning, all of us gathered here, put together, we are nothing compared to your grace. We're nothing compared to your presence. And so, sweet Holy Spirit of God, we welcome you this morning. You are welcome in this place. Be thou exalted, O Lord. Father, we give you praise. And so, Lord, by the authority conferred upon me this morning, in the name of Jesus, I usher this meeting open. In the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, and in the name of God the Holy Spirit. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. If you are a worshiper, shout hallelujah.
Said you should shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah one more time, please, to the glory of God. Turn to somebody beside you and say, the grace found me just as I am in Grace Assembly. Tell that person that grace will find you too today. Welcome to Power Hour Service. Praise the Lord. We're going to take our offering while standing, and we're going to use the congregational hymn. The congregational hymn is at the back of your bulletin. The congregational hymn is at the back of your bulletin. Once the basket goes round and we drop our offerings, those that have tithes can march to the front of the altar here and drop their tithes and go back to their seats as the choir will lead us. The hymn, Have You Been to Jesus for the Cleansing Power?
Bye.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you. King of glory, we are ever grateful for times like this to give in your vineyard. Father, as a reason of our giving today, Daddy, we are laying aside every garment that is stained with sin. Father, in replacement, we are wearing your garment of glory, and we are accepting the blessings that come with giving. King of glory, this morning, we are rest in you. We give you all the glory, and we're asking, Lord, that our hands will forever be on top. Ancient of days, every single one of us, Father, your grace will meet us today. King of glory, your grace will go before us. King of glory, your grace will tabernacle in our hearts. Father, whatever we have in our hearts of hearts, even as a reason of this token, Baba, today we're asking that you answer our prayers by fire. King of glory, your children who have given their tithes, Lord God Almighty, enlarge their coasts. Open doors where they never thought of. King of glory, before three will be called by them for in help. Father, King of glory, I'm asking that 10 would answer. Lord God Almighty, for this season, Father, as they step forward, Daddy, you will step forward with them. King of glory, even when they are tired, Father, you will lift them up. When they are weary, Daddy, King of glory, you will give them a heart of new beginning. Refresh us, O Lord, and ignite our spirit with your being. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty and everlasting name we are prayed. Somebody shout hallelujah.
The amazing grace. Choir is in red and black.
Yeah.
And red signifies the blood of the Lamb. The one that was shed on the cross of Calvary for you and I when we were wretched sinners. But this morning we're not going to talk about the blood. But we're going to talk about something that was bought with the blood. And that is mercy. And grace. And love. And compassion. This morning, the amazing grace choir is here to bless the Lord and bless you with a song titled, Good is Your Mercy Towards Us.
Yes.
I ask that your heart will melt this morning as you see the mercy and grace of God in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Mercy towards me.
your loving kindness, loving kindness towards us.
Oh, yes.
Your tender mercies I see day after day, forever faithful, faithful, faithful towards me. You're always, you keep on providing for me. Great is your mercy towards me. Great is your grace, your grace, your grace.
Is your mercy towards me.
Enjoy the mercy of God. Can you just put your hands together for Jesus? You can never quantify His mercy. You cannot quantify the mercy of God. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this morning. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your fidelity. Despite our infidelity, your fidelity towards us is constant. Thank you because of your mercy. Lord, we say thank you. Thank you for taking us from our richest state. Thank you for picking us from the mess of our life and in our righteousness. And you make us to be a message. Father, I say our thanks and praise in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray in today's service, speak to us as an individual and speak to every one of us collectively. In the name of Jesus, give us a hearing ears. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Come on, put your hands together for Jesus. God bless the choir. Put your hands together for them. Amen. And when you look at the hymn, when I just checked the hymn, I said the choir is in the spirit. Hallelujah. And the spirit of the Lord is one. Amen. So get ready. Because I look at the theme as I was coming for the theme for next month. It's going to be mercy in the blood. It's a definite article. Hallelujah. We'll be looking at the mercy, you know, the mercy in the blood. That will be the theme for next month. Hallelujah. And the Lord has been good unto us. From the beginning of the month to today, I will be very brief this morning. Hallelujah. But I want you to do something. I want you to be nice to yourself. And just as the word is coming, just take it and run with it. It may be a series that I start today. Amen. That it will continue till next month. Amen. So, Anna has been going to Shiloh year by year, year after year. But one day, one Shiloh was a Shiloh. And the prayer in that Shiloh was a prayer. Help me tell your neighbor to your right and to your left, today is your day. There are many days in the year and in the month, but one day is somebody's day. And I prophesy today will be your day. In the name of Jesus. There are so many hours in the day. Some people say we have, the scientists, they say we have 24 hours out of the 24 hours. But there is a particular hour that God will meet somebody. Even when Jesus Christ was talking to that woman, he said, and the hour has come. That means there is somebody's hour in the hours. And I prophesy, this hour shall be your hour. Amen. In the name of Jesus. In today's Power Hour service, I will just, where the Holy Spirit wants me to stop, I will stop. If this morning you need to just rise up on your feet and pray. And I will beg you, and if I tell you to stand up to pray, please pray. Amen. Ephesians chapter 6 verse 18. He said, pray with all prayers. That means your prayer is in the prayers. And you don't know the prayer that you are going to pray in a very particular place that will be your prayer. And I prophesy, as you pray today, today's prayer shall be your prayer. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Today I'll be looking at blood issues. Blood issues. I will start this series with what? Blood issues. Mark chapter 5 verse 25. Mark chapter 5 verse 25. Mark chapter 5 verse 25. And a certain woman which had an issue of blood 12 years. And he has suffered many things of many physicians, and has spent all that she had, and was nothing, but nothing better, but rather grew worse. When she heard of Jesus, came in the press behind and touched his garment. For she said, if I may touch but his clothes, I shall be whole. And straightway the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she was felt in her body that she was ill of that plague. As you touch Jesus by faith, the healing virtue in his blood will flow to you this morning. In the name of Jesus. This woman has issues of blood. Sir, these issues of blood had a period. And it is a period of what? 12 years. Some people in life, they have problem. And if you begin to count them, you know, the number of years, months, some may be even more than this woman's years of challenges. If you look at the scripture, it has a period because it has time. 12 years. She has what? Issues of blood. And she has suffered many things of many physicians. And she has spent all that she had, and nothing better, but rather grow worse. At times, when you look at your life, it's like you have spent all that you have, and yet the situation is not getting better. And you have suffered so much in the hand of the physician. But this woman, she has suffered in the hand of the physician for many years. But when she heard of Jesus, as we are hearing Jesus this morning, that he can heal and he can deliver, this woman in her mind said, if only people can touch Jesus, people can have a handshake with him, some people can eat with him in the same plate, some people can sleep in the same house with him, just like the disciples, they can travel with him with the same, on what? In the same boat. He said, but I don't, this woman said, the problem that I have is not about this boat. It's not about eating with him. It's not about sleeping in the same house. But only if I can just touch the hem of his garment, I'll be made whole. What he's saying, what she was saying is that I just need to touch Jesus by faith. She has been hearing about Jesus. Romans chapter 10 verse 17. He said, faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. She has heard about Jesus severally. And her faith built, you know, her faith was built up. And she said, I will only if I can touch. I don't know how many people have faith here this morning. That's this long problem in my life, if only I can pray. You have faith. I said, if I pray about it this morning, everything will disappear. This woman, she had that kind of faith. If only, I don't need to have a handshake. I just need what? His garments. I just need a touch of his garment. I need a touch of his cloth only. And when she did that, she was made whole. At times, our faith can shake. Amen. You said, people to look at Jesus, they said, Jesus is the great physician. That's what they know about Jesus. In fact, some people, what did they hear about Jesus? Jesus Christ can supply you food, bread. So, Jesus Christ was in the crowd, and the people were running after him to do what? To get the next bread. But this woman does not need bread. She needs healing. Her problem is what? Healing. And she went straight for the healing. Many of us, we have been hearing the word of God. Jesus Christ himself is the word. In John chapter 1 verse 1, he said, in the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and God is the word. Jesus Christ is what? Is the word. You have been hearing the word. So that means Jesus Christ, every time that you come to church like this, Jesus Christ is appearing to you. Because Jesus is the word. And is equally what? Appearing to you. Hebrews 13 verse 8. He said, Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever. Can I substitute that John chapter 1 in the same Hebrews 13 verse 8? That now reads that the word the same yesterday, the word the same today, and the word forever. That means you have been hearing the word of God. If it was powerful then, but that is the word yesterday, and it is the word today. If the word that appeared to this woman, because she had it, healed this woman yesterday, the same word has the same power today to do what? To heal you. And tomorrow, if you still read the same word, it's what? It has power to deliver you. So the word now reads, the word the same yesterday, the word today, the same word today, and the same word forever. The power in the word yesterday is the same power in the word today. As the word is coming to you, this woman is hearing the word of God. And as it is coming to you and is appearing to you as well, Jesus Christ is the word personified. And the word is equally coming to you today. How do you get the word? Do you touch that word by faith and say, I receive it? It is very possible for a man of God to release. Another thing is for you to grab. What I discovered in life is that, or in the scripture, the problem is not at the giving end. The problem is always at the receiving end. The Lord has spoken once, and twice have I heard this, that all power belongs to God. God does not need to revert. He doesn't need to repeat himself. The word has gone forth. So yours is to do what? To take it. I like somebody that says, faith is like Wi-Fi. Yes, the faith is like Wi-Fi. As you are in this place, there are so many things in the air. When you put on your Wi-Fi, you receive. Am I correct? You have access into the internet. No wonder the Bible says it is impossible to please God. For you to have access to God, you need faith. So your faith, the word has been released. All the information, the information on the internet is released into the air. You just need your Wi-Fi to do what? To just switch your Wi-Fi on and receive what has been released into the air. The word of God has gone forth. For you to now receive and begin to access those things is what? You need your Wi-Fi, which is your faith. Just like this woman, and take it and grab it. And said, this issue must just go away. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 40b. He said, God has something better in store for us. But it requires we and God to make it perfect. If you want to change your word, you change your word. Your word, what? You want to change your world? You will change your word, the word that are coming out of you. You speak what heaven is speaking. Amen. For this woman, she had faith and she has access to solve it. She now got a healing via faith. In the case of this woman, she has issues of blood. And all of us, I'm talking about blood issue this morning. We have issues in life. When you look at this woman, you say, that is her problem. She only has issue of blood. What about you? Don't you have issues in life? Every man has got issues. And in this, there are some, there are issues of children, issues of family, issues of in-laws, issues of education, issue money, issue home, issue trying to make ends meet. There are some people that have issues of emotion. There are issues of time. Some have issues of drug. Some have issues of idolatry. These are issues in life. We have so many issues. There are some, they say, I can't just stop smoking. That woman has this, she, in her own case, is the issue of blood. And some of these things that are mentioned as issue, when you trace them, you can trace them to blood, sir. To your blood, your DNA, what makes up you, that makes you you. When you go to hospital, and the doctor wants to diagnose you, or you have, you said headache, the doctor will even equally ask you, is there any member of your family, your parents, do they have headache like this before? Your siblings? Anybody in your family? That means there is issue somewhere. So, if it is blood, that means there are issues there. There are some, when I talk about issue of children, some of us today will beat our children. And when you check them closely, sir, it is your issues that you have not dealt with. You didn't pray about them. Genesis chapter 1, verse 24. He said, every living creature after their kind. And what? Every living creature, what? They bring forth after their kind. You may beat your child for certain things, but can I tell you the truth? If you look at your life critically, or the life of your wife, there is a trace of what you are beating your child for in that blood, in that family lineage. Because the Bible says, and they bring forth their kind. If you have ever seen somebody who is always lying and he gives birth to a child, give that child naturally, give that child 3 years when the child starts talking. Without teaching the child how to lie, she will lie nicely. Where did she learn that from? From where? You will beat that child. You are bad. You are this. I remember many years ago, two of them, they were teenagers, born of the same father, of the same mother. He said, these children, there is nothing that they cannot steal. They were beating them. In fact, when you see all their bodies full of marks, and I just asked the mother a question, what about the father of these children? Their father is an arm robber. And why are you beating the children? You didn't deal with the blood, the issue there. Okay, I mean, God wants me to say this one. My son, one day, I think he was just 2.5 years, and he just did something. And as he did, and the way he answered, and I just look at him, I say, yes, this is Sunday. you understand? And I said, that means that he carry a particular gene. Amen. The same way I will react when I was young, that was the same way he reacted. Amen. The same way what that I will have reacted is the same way he reacted. That is issue in the blood. If it is negative, it is going to be like that. If it is positive, except it is dealt with, it will be like that. I remember 1998, December 25. when everybody, they were busy taking, eating chicken and visiting friend, I stood before God. And on this issue that you see, blood issue, I say, God, I want this one. I don't want it to be passed down to my children yet unborn. I was not married then. I was not married. But there are traces. And even the wife that I want to marry and the children that I want to have, I say, God, let me first deal with this issue in my own lineage first, then the issue. So it's something that runs from the family. It's your gene. Amen. You don't deal with them, they will come up one day to deal with you. When you look at your life very well, and you look at the life of your parents, your father, or your mother, just check at a particular age in their life, something happens to them. When you are very close to that age, check it, it will come. I can't finish this subject today, but I'm just introducing. Amen. It will do what? It will just raise its head and say, gentlemen, I am here. There are some people in the family, maybe there was a curse that is placed over that family for a very long time. You will see people who are beautiful. When you see them, the summary by human standard is that they are very beautiful. Yet, they will not be married. In fact, some will not even have somebody that will say, excuse me. What is the problem? You better check the family lineage very well. I came from a particular state in Nigeria. And I was trying to make research when it comes to this blood issue. I discovered that most of our women, they will get married. After some time, they will return back to their father's house. And it's like it's common. It's a common thing in that land. And they are proud about it. I don't know how some people will be proud about something that is not correct. And it's an issue. At a particular time, you will see. You can imagine a woman who will be married for 30 years. And after 30 years, maybe 31 years, and said, I'm going back to my father's house. Ah, Lagomelo. What time of the day? And if you check that person, the grandmother is the same. The one before the grandmother is the same way, the same style, the same time. I know a lady who got pregnant in secondary school at a particular age. But the time we check the mother, exact time, the exact age that the mother gave, you know, got pregnant of that lady, is the exact year, exact time. And the lady too, when she grew to that very particular age, the same thing happens to her. The same way, the same scheming that a man schemed the mother is the same way another man schemed the daughter. Same way they gave birth. How do you want to define that? Is a family, is what? Is a blood issue that needs to what? Be dealt with. Some, if your father is a smoker, you will make up your mind this morning and say, God, this one must stop from me. You will tell me, say, in fact, there are some people, their father drinks. And they, in fact, by the time they drink to stupor. You will need to tell God Almighty that this one must stop. At times when they talk to them, maybe you say, bro, how are you? Are you smoking? Stop smoking now. Oh, You are telling the man to stop the act. What about the art? Inside the blood, the, you know, out of the art is the issues of life. The art, you have not dealt with the art. You have not dealt with the blood that is inside, that is going into the art. And you tell the man, stop smoking. You think the man will stop smoking? If you start something, you know that you have started something. Something is going inside your blood that will be passed down to your children. Hallelujah. Some that is smoking, at times even this wine and alcohol is the same. Some will say, Pastor, I am tired. I don't know what to do. I am just but tired. I don't know what to do. I know this thing is bad though. It's bad. But what about your blood? Is there? You need to pray about it. We read a book in secondary school. Is it Things Fall Apart? There is one man called Okonkwo. Okonkwo. And Emeka, his father. The man will drink and is a very lazy man. But this man, Okonkwo, said, I don't want to resemble my father in any way. How many of us are resolute like that? That you can say this thing should not be passed down to children after me. That this thing should stop here. If women don't, in fact, there are some family, they don't get engaged to be married until they are 40. Sorry, sir, it's in the family lineage, inside what? The blood. Somebody needs to stand and say, this nonsense must stop. And if you don't stop it now, as the thing goes on, it gets worse. Just like the issue of this woman. The issue of blood, when it started, the Bible says what? It did not do what? It did not get better. Rather, it grew what? It grew worse. Judah, the grandfather of David, slept with his own son that died, the wife of his own son that died. That is not right. That's another man's wife, right? When it was the turn of David, what did he do? He looked at a woman. He had other wives, so he looked at her and said, this one, get her for me. If, and the man made sure that he killed the husband of that woman. Amen. He said what? He killed the husband of that woman. His own children. His own children is what? When it comes to the children, Tamar and Amnon, they now slept with themselves. Inside. Right? And when the other stepbrother had, they said, with my sister, his own father killed another man to take his wife. So his own brother took vengeance and killed his own stepbrother to do what? To take revenge. You see how it is going? At the beginning, it was external. Now it has now come inside the home. And it's even getting worse. Because it's what? It's an issue of blood. And when you begin to trace it down, in fact, when you look at David, he had people around him in the palace. He said, who is that woman? He make an inquiry. For his own son, he even called his friend. He said, I am almost sick to death. I just need this woman. The father called the chiefs. His own son called his friends and said, this is what I want. He was talking about issues in the same blood. And they begin to kill themselves. There are some traces that you find in your father and in your mother. And today you still see this sexual immorality. Some, they took, in fact, it's running in the family lineage. In fact, it's nothing but, you say, I just try to stop. You will cry this morning and just stop them. It should not be passed down to your children. Hallelujah. Rise up on your feet and tell God Almighty, these issues of blood, Lord, every negative things that is inside my blood, that is affecting my life and affecting my destiny, Lord, flush it out with your blood this morning. Begin to pray. I want you to begin to measure them. Those things that are inside your parents, and you don't want them in your life, tell God Almighty, Lord, flush it out. Today they will tell you, don't drink, don't smoke. It's in the system, it's in the blood, it's an issue. Lord, flush it out of my system. If you are a loving father, you will stop it in your time. Lord, flush it out. Lord, flush it out. It's not about money, sir. It's not that I give my children good education. Hey, if it's in the blood, the thing will still come. Everything that is negative, that is in this blood system, that is in my blood, I flush it out with the blood of Jesus. I flush it out with the blood of Jesus. I flush it out with the blood of Jesus. I flush it out with the blood of Jesus. I flush it out with the blood of Jesus. I flush it out with the blood of Jesus. I flush it out with the blood of Jesus. I flush it out with the blood of Jesus. I flush it out with the blood of Jesus. The Bible says, every tree which my heavenly Father has not planted shall be uprooted. Lord, I uproot them in my being. Everything in my blood that is negative, Lord, I remove them this morning. Let them be uprooted. In Jesus' name we pray. I think somebody should pray this morning. Hey, sir, this thing, if you don't stop it in your time and be passed down. I was listening to a man of God one day. I think that is Ashimolo. He's from my estate. He said, apart from him that prayed very well, all his sisters married and came back to their father's house. Oh, you think we are joking here? If your father is a drunkard, you need to pray. If you are a smoker and your father smokes, you need to pray. If adultery is running in either of your parents, you should pray. And say, God, let it stop from me. If in your family there are so many things, people don't get married. In fact, there are some families, in fact, they will get first class. But the kind of job that they will have in life will not be sufficient to feed them. That is walking like elephant and eating like an ant. And when you check the whole family, they will be the same. Some of them will even pride themselves that they will have PhD. Which PhD? Pull their head down. I want you to hold the hand of somebody and pray for that person from the bottom of your heart. Everything in this blood system of this person that I'm holding, Lord, I pray, flush it out with your blood. Everything that is negative in the life of this person that I'm holding, Lord, flush it out with your blood. Lord, flush it out with your blood. Lord, flush it out with your blood. Anything negative in this my brother's lineage, in this my brother's lineage, in this my sister's lineage, Lord, I flush it out with the blood of Jesus. Lord, flush it out with the blood of Jesus. 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 I flush it out with the blood of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. There is power, there is power, there is power in the blood. Power, there is power, there is power in the blood.
There is power, there is power.
I want you to sing and clap.
There is power, there is power, there is power. power in the blood.
There is power, there is power, there is power in the blood.
There is power, miracle power, there is power in the blood.
Turn it into prayer. Lord, the power in your blood, let it flush out every negative power in my blood. That power in your blood, let it flush every negative power in my system that is operating. Flush it out. There is power in the blood of Jesus. You just get angry unnecessarily. You destroy things. If you check, your father did the same. Your siblings are doing the same. Lord, every power that is at work in my blood, let your power flush it out. There is power in your blood. In Jesus' name we pray. I want to, this morning is very serious, all eyes closed. Sir, there is no amount of prayer I will pray for you now if you don't reconcile with God. Your blood needs to have connection with the blood of Jesus that is shed on the cross of Calvary. If you look at your life very well, only people that are sincere, I don't want this religious resting in your hand. And if you want to give your life to Jesus, you want to reconcile, before I go ahead and pray, I want to see your hand up. You want to sincerely, not religion, or this religion, I want to give my life. No. All eyes closed. Let me see your hand up. Sincerely, Jesus Christ can only save you if only. God bless you. I like that sincerity. If only you only surrender unto the Lord Jesus, this prayer will only work in your life. If you want to give your life to Jesus, you will just battle with those with devices in your life, and the ones that you inherited, and the ones that is placed on you. Amen. If you are raising your hand, let me see you properly. All eyes closed. Let us pray. That person raising up, those people raising up their hand, if I can see them clearly, I want you to just tell the Lord Jesus to take you back home. Sincerely, take me back home. Take me back home. I've gone astray. Please, ushers, look at those people that are raising up their hands, please. And just want you to pray sincerely. Lord, take me back home. I repent this morning. And those of you, I don't do this. Praise the Lord. I don't do this, but I've just led to do this. If you are raising up your hand, just come. I want to pray for you especially. Come. Those of you that are raising, all eyes closed. Just come. Come to the front here. God bless you. Just come. Name we pray.
Amen.
Father, we thank you for your word that has gone forth. Lord, your word causes it to germinate in the life of your people. In the name of Jesus, as many that are having issues in life, as you, your virtue went to the source of that woman's problem and the issue of blood ceased immediately, Lord, I pray, put an end to every issues of their lives.
Amen.
Everyone that is battling with issues in their blood, in their blood system, Lord, I pray, let that issue come to an end today.
Amen.
There are some vices that you are battling with for many years. I speak like the oracle of God over your life. That vices come to an end today.
Amen.
That blood issue is terminated today.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I proclaim your liberty today.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If you took it from your parents, I speak over your life and over that blood, that comes to an end today.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every evil vices that is running in the family blood and that is affecting you, affecting your destiny, it comes to an end in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Everything in your blood that is affecting your life, affecting your destiny, affecting your children, affecting your siblings, affecting your home, affecting your family, it comes to an end today in the name of Jesus. Everything in your blood that is affecting your business, affecting you, your place of work, it comes to an end in the name of Jesus. I prophesy over your life that you go and begin to do well. Go and begin to prosper in the name of Jesus. When you met that woman with the issue of blood for 12 years and it comes to an end that day, I don't know the number of years that you have been facing these challenges and you have been battling with these issues in your life. The word of the Lord said that day that the woman touched you, the problem comes to an end. Every one of us, we touch you by faith. Oh Lord, I pray every problem in the bloodline, let it come to an end this morning.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
never to be passed down to the next generation, in the name of Jesus. He said, if the Son of Man shall set you free, you shall be free indeed. I proclaim your liberty. I proclaim your freedom in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Come on, put your hands together for Jesus. If you are blessed, come on, put your hands together for Jesus.